Thank you for checking out my video. If you are unsure on how to properly charge a battery, or you just need a little more information on how to use a charger, stay tuned and I will walk you through the whole process. Charging a battery is very simple, but before we go ahead and charge one of these batteries, let's go over the type of batteries that can be charged. So what you see here are samples of batteries. The first one here is the lead acid battery. This is your typical household battery. You can use this to run your electric motor, your electric bike, or your scooter, and so forth. I'm sure you've seen these before. This one here is a lithium ion battery. Lithium ion batteries are very popular nowadays, especially with iPhone, laptop computers, and with the electric car. This is actually the 2170 battery cell that Tesla uses on its Model 3. So these three batteries here are all rechargeable batteries. So you want to make sure that before you charge your batteries, these batteries are rechargeables. Now, there are other types of rechargeable batteries that are out there, but I only have these three samples for you. The non-rechargeable batteries are these guys here. These are the typical alkaline batteries. You can see the Kirkland brand here. This is a AA, and the AAA is smaller. And you have your typical 9-volt Duracell battery, as well as your C batteries. So these guys are non-rechargeable, so you can't charge these guys. Once the juice are out, you have to recycle them. Just make sure that the batteries are rechargeable before you charge them. Alright, so let's get these guys out of the way. So the other thing that you should be aware of your battery is the battery rating. So here you see two key information on the battery. The first one is the voltage level, and that is rated at 12 volts. So when you charge your battery, you want to make sure that the charger is rated for 12 volts as well. And then the second number here is the amp hour rating. So this battery is rated for 7 amp hour at 20 hours. So what you do is you divide 20 by 7, and then you get the amount of amp that you can discharge that will work efficiently within 20 hours. All right, so you do your own calculation, and whatever the number is, that's how much the battery can continue to discharge within the 20 hours period. So that's sort of the key information that you need to look at. And when you purchase a battery itself, you want to make sure that you understand the amp hour rating, because it tells you the capacity of the battery. The more amp hours that you have in the battery, the longer time that you can use it, depending on the amount of current you are drawing out. This one here, on the other hand, is the lithium ion battery. Same kind of information, they'll give you the voltage level. This one is rated at 36 volts, so it has 30,000 milliamp hours, or 30 amp hours. Although it's just a little slightly bigger than the lead acid battery, it has way more capacity or energy density, and obviously it's going to last way longer than this guy here. So these are some key information that you need to be aware of when you purchase a battery. It'll also help when you charge a battery in terms of how long it will take for your battery to charge. Before we go on to the charger, I also wanted to point out some other key features here. So here you see on this lead acid battery two terminals, and the positive terminal is always painted red, so you know which charging terminal you should connect it to when you're charging. And then the negative is always black. Okay, just be mindful to pay attention to these guys. Now, for this lithium ion battery here, this is a battery pack. So inside this battery, there are multiple cells in this battery that are packed together in a combinations of parallel and series connection in order to achieve the 35 volts and the amp hour rating. There is a circuit in here. What is a little bit different here is that they give you a terminal wires like this. This is the battery terminals themselves, and you can directly connect it to a load. But for charging purposes, they also give you a charging terminal like this one here. So it will be different when you're charging in terms of the type of charger that you need to purchase for each of these batteries. So that is just something to keep in mind. Now that we know what type of batteries you can charge and what type you cannot charge, let's take a look at the charger themselves. Like I said, charging the battery is pretty easy. All you have to do is plug it into your wall outlet, and then connect charger terminals to your battery. All right, so I'll do that in a minute. Here are a few samples of battery charger. You can get these guys from Amazon or eBay. All you have to do is go into the search box and type 12 volt charger and you'll look at a list of options. I would recommend getting a smart charger like these guys here, and that's because they have electronic components to charge your battery safer, as well as its ability to stop charging the battery when it reaches a certain level. These chargers come with LED indicator. It'll tell you when the battery is charging. Usually the indicator will show up as red, and then when it's full, it's green. I'll plug this in later and you can see it for yourself. This one is also a smart charger. This one has two options. You can either charge a 6 volt or 12 volt. So these two here, they have the plug to the outlet. You can just stick into your wall and then attach this terminals to the batteries, red to positive, black to negative, like so. And then just plug into your wall and you know the indicator will show the voltage, the current level. For lithium ion batteries, it's different. So this is the charger for it. Here, you plug this into the outlet, and then you plug this terminal into the battery itself, right? So it comes with a compatible terminal where you can just, you know, plug it in and charge it like that, right? So when you purchase a lithium ion battery pack, you want to make sure that you're able to find a compatible battery charger. This one is also a smart charger and it comes with a light indicator, you know, red showing that it's charging, and then when it turns green, it's telling you that it's full so you can stop charging. When you purchase a battery charger, you want to pay attention to the information on the back. First, you'll see your typical input power, and input power for all the chargers are AC power, that is alternating current. These are the power that you get from your wall, right? So they usually run from 120 to 240 at 50 to 60 megahertz. Once the AC power enter the charger adapter here, there is a transformer that will step down the 120 to 42. This is a 36 volt battery. The charger is rated at 42. But you can charge it to a 36. The charger can have a little higher voltage than the actual battery. So you want to look at the output information here, whether it's 12, 36, 42, depending on the battery you're charging. So you don't want to use this 42 to charge a 12 volt battery. It's just not compatible. But you can use this to charge a 36 volt battery. So the second number, just like the battery rating, you want to see the amps rating. So this is the amount of amp or current that you can charge your battery with. So the bigger the number, the faster it will charge your battery. Like this one here, for example, this is a 12 volt charger. It has a 6 amp capacity charging current. So you can charge it at a very fast pace. But I would charge it with a bigger battery, like because the bigger battery can take more amps. So you want to pay attention to that, especially charging current, because you want to make sure that you charge your battery as fast as possible. If you get a lower charging current, it might take you a longer time to completely charge your battery. All right, so you want to pay attention to these guys here as well.
Before we charge the batteries, I just want to go over some safety tips. I mentioned earlier about this smart charger here and that it has a discharge rating of 6 amp. So unfortunately, you cannot supercharge your lead acid battery. It's just the way it is with battery. So in other words, do not try to use this charger with a 6 amp discharge capability on this small battery, okay? Because if you put too much current in the battery when you're charging the battery, it will heat up the battery. And batteries do not like heat. The battery can explode, and if not, you can damage the internal chemistry, and then it will not work effectively. For this one, use a smaller one, okay? Use the one with the discharge rate of 2 amps, like what you're seeing here. So it's gonna be slow, it's not gonna be fast, but it will get the job done, and you'll get a healthier battery and a fully charged battery. Now for this one, you see here, I purchased this one for the bigger battery here. It has a 35 amp hours rating on it. So the big battery is able to handle more current coming from this charger, and it won't damage the battery and it won't heat up the battery. And again, these smart chargers, they're great. They charge the batteries in stages. It knows when to put a certain amount of current into the battery, especially when the battery is empty, and when it will start to lower the level of current and then give it enough voltage to make sure that the battery is fully charged and so forth. Again, you can't supercharge your battery. You just have to be patient and use the chargers that are appropriate for the size and the capacity of the battery.
With that, let's charge the battery and see what it looks like. When charging a lead acid battery, you always have to make sure that the positive line from the charger go to the positive terminal of the battery, okay? The same thing with the negative terminal of the charger, it goes to the negative terminal of the battery. Just be mindful, check one or twice just to make sure. You don't want to get hurt, you want to be careful, okay? So this is my battery charging station here. So this is a lithium ion battery that you saw earlier. So charging is just a matter of picking the right charger, and then once you have it, it's just a matter of plugging in the cord to the here in the wall, right? So as you see, there's a green light indicator here, and then you just plug the terminal together like so. So now it's showing that it's charging, and the light indicator here is red. Once the charging is complete, and then it'll become green, and from there you can just disconnect the power cord, and then you have a fully charged battery. So it's really simple, okay? So next we have the lead acid battery. I'm going to charge it with a 12 volt charger here. It's a smart charger. And so this one is a little bit different than the lithium iron battery pack, again, because this one comes with two terminals, alligator clips here. You have to manually, you know, connect the clip to the red, goes to red and then black. I usually tap it like that. So sometimes they have a spark and I want to get the spark out of the way. So once you connect it, right, you simply plug this guy into the wall and then like so, let me see, boom, the light indicator is showing red. That means it's charging. And once it's completely charged, then this will turn green. And once you're done, just unplug it like so from the terminal, boom, and then plug out of the wall and you're done. Very simple. With that, thank you for watching my video. Don't forget to check out my other projects on YouTube. And if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe. That would be awesome. Thank you, and I hope to see you again soon.